Hello students, welcome to Wisdom Academy. I am Nasreen and today we will be continuing with the halo compounds unit. Last class we have seen the classification, nomenclature and CX bond type of halo compounds, and today in this session we will be seeing the preparation of halo compounds, how they are prepared from another chemical substances. So we have five methods of preparing halo compounds. The first one is from alcohols. It has the alkyl group with OH. So this OH group should be replaced by X group. So this is nothing but a simple substitution reaction. So we will have the same R group. Only thing is, instead of OH group, we will have a halogen group. So the first method is using any HX group, and the catalyst used here is zinc chloride. So this OH and this H will come out of water, and this X will be attached with the R group. So this is also a simple substitution reaction. Then with phosphorus trihalides, we have three, for one phosphorus trihalide we should take three alcohol group. So we will get three alkyl halide with phosphoric acid. So the ratio should be 1:3, that is PX3 plus 3ROH group. So this should be the ratio. Then with phosphorus pentachloride, this is 1:1 ratio, because in this 5 halogens, only 1 halogen will be attached to the R group. 3 halogen will be with the phosphoxide group. Then 1 halogen will be H as hydroacids. So only 1 halogen is taken, the ratio is 1:1. Then addition of X2 in presence of red phosphorus, here also the ratio is 1:1. So you get only one RX molecule. Then we have sulfuryl chloride. In sulfuryl chloride, we have two chlorine, in which one chlorine will be attached with the R group, one chlorine will be with the hydrogen of hydroxyl group, and SO releases SO2 gas. So this is the reaction. Then the last one is with sodium bromide presence of sulfuric acid. Bromine, this is also substitution reaction. Bromine will go to the R group and it will have sodium bisulfate and water molecule. So in this, all this reaction, they are called halogenating reaction reagents, because they are giving halogen compounds to the R group. So OH group should be replaced by the halogen atom. So this is how compounds prepared from alcohol, simple substitution reaction. We have HX, phosphorus trichloride, phosphorus pentachloride, halogen, sulfuryl chloride, sodium bromide. So next one is from hydrocarbons. So this is basically a free radical mechanism. A free radical mechanism means it goes not as a carbocation on carbon end, the reaction goes via carbene formation. We have already seen what is carbocation, carbanion, carbene, etc. So here, if this is a reagent, we have two types of carbon. We know what is primary carbon, secondary carbon, tertiary carbon. Primary carbon is nothing but the carbon should be attached to only one carbon or no carbon. Methyl is a primary carbon which is attached to no other carbon. Secondary carbon, it should be attached with two carbon. Tertiary carbon, it should be attached with three carbon. This is primary carbon, secondary carbon, tertiary carbon. Here we have two types. This is primary carbon attached with one carbon. This is also primary carbon attached with one carbon. But this carbon, which is in the center, it is secondary carbon. It is attached to two carbon atoms. So we have two types of carbon atom with same environment. One is primary carbon, these two are primary carbon. The second one is secondary carbon. So when you do halogenation in presence of light or heat, we get two types. One is the halogen atom attached with the primary carbon. Another one is the halogen atom attached with the secondary carbon. So in this method, you get mixture of compounds, primary halide and secondary halide. So this is free radical mechanism. It depends on the number of types of carbon atoms you have. You have primary, secondary, you get two mixtures. If you have all the three, primary, secondary, tertiary, you get all those mixtures. Then Sandmeyer reaction, which is very important naming reaction. So in Sandmeyer reaction, the reactant is aniline. So in benzene ring, NH2 group will be attached. So to aniline we have to add sodium nitrate and any acid, HCl, HBr, any HX acid at 0 degree Celsius. So we get a compound something like this, C6H5N2+X-. This is called benzene diazonium halide. It is very important raw material for preparing many compounds. Here we are taking any cuprous salt. In this cuprous salt, the X should be chlorine and bromine, because usually in this method we cannot prepare any fluoro or iodo compound, because we all know fluorine is highly reactive, it is very explosive in nature, and iodine is very less electronegative. It has many electropositive character. So iodine also doesn't give many product, and fluorine is very reactive. So fluorine and iodine will have many less compound compared to chloro and bromo compounds. So X which we use in cuprous salt will be chloro and bromo compound. We get halogen compound with evolution of nitrogen gas. So if we need any iodo compound, then what we can do is, with the same benzene diazonium chloride, we can add potassium iodide, any strong iodine salt. We get any strong iodine salt, we get iodo benzene. So this is Sandmeyer reaction. Aniline is converted to benzene diazonium chloride, and this benzene diazonium chloride reacts with many salts to give halo compounds. The fourth one is halogen exchange. So usually I said we have chloro and bromo compounds, but in case if we need any fluorine or any iodine compound, then we will go for halogen exchange. So we have two types, Finkelstein and Schwartz. In Finkelstein, we get any chloro and bromo, we have any chloro or bromo compound, we have to treat with a strong iodine salt like sodium iodine. We treat with strong iodine salt. The X compound, which is X atom which is present in R group, will be taken by sodium, and the iodine will come and attach to the R group. So we get iodo compound. The second one is Schwartz. In Schwartz, we get fluoro compound. Any, it's not bromine, we can even take even chlorine compound also. If we take any silver salt of fluorine, then we get fluoro compound and silver salt, silver bromide or silver chloride. So for iodine it is Finkelstein, for fluorine it is Schwartz. Then the fifth one is from alkenes. In this one method, that is Morikonikov of addition, we have already seen 11th standard in hydrocarbons. We have something called Morikonikov rule of addition, that is the positively charged species will go to the carbon which has more number of hydrogen. So in this double bonded carbon, olefinic carbon, this carbon has more hydrogen, so this H will go here, become CH3, and the X will go here. So Morikonikov addition we have already seen in 11th standard. So we have two types of compound. One is major, which follows Morikonikov addition. The second one is minor, which doesn't follow Morikonikov addition. So we have major product and minor product. So you get two types of product here also. The second method from alkenes is just add halogen, chlorine, bromine, any halogen gas. But here what we get is, you get dihalo compounds. Already we have seen in classification, from all these methods we prepare only monohalogen compound, but from directly adding halogen gas we get dihalo compounds. And this type of compounds are called vicinal compounds. So we have two types, vicinal and geminal. If two adjacent carbon have halogens, it is vicinal. But if the same carbon has two halogen, it is geminal. So we have two types, geminal and vicinal. If same carbon has two halogen, it is geminal. If adjacent carbon has halogens attached with each carbon, they are called vicinal. So this is a preparation from alcohols. It is just simply a substitution reaction with many halogenating agents. Second one is from hydrocarbon, which follows free radical mechanism. Here we get mixture of halogen compounds based on types of carbon. You have primary, secondary and tertiary. Third one is Sandmeyer reaction, in which you prepare benzene diazonium chloride and we treat that with many salts to get halogen compounds. Fourth one is halogen exchange, to convert chloro or bromo halo compounds to iodo and fluoro. Finkelstein is for iodo and Schwartz is for fluoro. The fifth one is from alkenes. We have two types in this also, Morikonikov addition, which give you major product and minor product, and the second one is addition of X2, which give you vicinal products. And in this Morikonikov addition, we have already studied one more thing called anti-Morikonikov addition. That is, we have something called, if this is like major and this product is minor, if you use any reagent like hydrogen peroxide or any peroxide, the major product will become minor product and a minor product will become major product. So this thing also we have already seen in 11th standard, that is called anti-Markovnikov addition or even called peroxide effect, all those things. So if you want to change the minor product to major product, then you have to use some reagent like peroxide, hydrogen peroxide or alkyl peroxide, some any strong peroxides. So this is something called anti-Markovnikov addition, that based on upon our interest of which product we want as major product and which product we want as a minor product. This is the five major methods of preparing halo compounds. In coming session we will be seeing the properties like physical property, chemical property and some types of mechanism like substitution reaction mechanism, then elimination reaction mechanism, all those things. Like the video, subscribe to our channel, share with your friends.